folks come out of hand. We want to walk around with a chain and be crippled. But the devil is a lie. Because it's time for us to rise up in a place that we know God for ourselves. We got to. Because if not, we'll be like the children of Israel. We'll be forming gods. We'll be looking for people and places and things to make us feel whole.
Come on.
Not knowing ain't no wholeness without God.
Make plain.
Man, that's it. That's good.
Clean your house. And see, I ain't just talking about just be talking somebody, not somebody else, but God is saying for us too. Even for me preaching too, like I just said, I had to go through my house and God showing me things I need to get rid of. Even things that I overlooked it and think that's harmless and okay. And see, what even God was saying, even with cleaning house, even things that even in our mindsets. I wrote down here saying that we got to get rid of these things, these mindsets that will keep us back in Egypt. See, the thing about it, that their mindsets kept them back in Egypt where they couldn't go forward. Because the way they was thinking, a lot of times we believe in God and we trust in God, and some people say, well, I ain't seen God move yet. Mm-hmm. I ain't seen nothing happen yet. You ain't going to see nothing happen because your mind is still in the past. Your mind is behind you. How can you see God moving? You looking backwards.
Wow.
But we saying, I need God to do this. Or I ain't going to church, or I ain't reading my Bible, I ain't doing this because I ain't seen God move. How you going to see God move when your head is turned backwards? When God is before you. The Bible said in the Word that he led the people by cloud by day and fire by night. So if the Word said he led the people, that means he had to be in front of them. Where are we looking? And what do we have in our house to keep us from looking forward? What people that we have in our lives to keep us from looking forward? Because the Bible tells us to keep our eyes on him. He's our way. He said, my words are light to your feet that you will not stumble. Amen?
Amen.
But the Bible said that Moses delayed and the people got in a ruckus.
Amen.
And as the day turned to 2012, and people can't get hold of a pastor, they can't get hold of a first lady, they can't get hold of somebody, they're in a ruckus. Because they don't know God for themselves. See, that's what God wants. He's tired of playing church. He's tired of the religious church. He wants you to know him for yourself.
Oh, yeah.
He wants a relationship.
Cut the
biblical cord. He wants a relationship. Because I don't know nobody want to be shacking with nobody. Just to be going on carrying on and they do something wrong with them.
Yeah.
You want a relationship.
Man.
I want to be intimate with you. I want to grow with you. And see, that's what God is saying. I want to grow with you. I want to grow in you.
Yes.
Don't shack with me because I don't want to shack. I got standards.
Yes.
God said he got standards. I don't want to shack.
No.
I don't want you to come to me halfway. I want all of you.
Yes.
So those things in your life that's hindering you, clean it out.
Yes.
Clean it out where I can't move on you. Pastor just said last week, the reason why God can't move because we got his hands tied. It ain't nothing that the devil is doing. It's been too long. The church been giving the devil too much credit.
Yes.
The devil did it. The devil did it. I found the devil. The devil sitting there laughing. Saying, fool, it's you.
That's it.
I ain't did nothing yet. I ain't got to do nothing. You know it's for me.
Come on.
Because you don't know his word. It's bad for your enemy to tell you you don't know the strategies. You don't know the word for yourself. And he sit back and laugh at us. That's why the Bible says, instead of to show by self-approval. Know the word for yourself. That's just like going to a classroom. If you don't do your studying, if you don't be in a classroom to listen, how can you pass the test?
God.
And see, the thing about with this, God says it's an open book test. So if you fail because you ain't even opened your book.
Lord.
We fail in life, and the church fail in life because we don't even open our book. We want somebody to tell us. We want somebody to do it for us. But God ain't going to allow for it to happen. Amen?
Amen.
In verse 2, that Aaron, see, Aaron, by him being a priest, he got shaken. And see, that's what us that we got to be so rooted. And I thank God for leadership, our pastor. We got to be in a place where we're so rooted where we can't be shaken by the people. See, we came too far to let people shake us. That's why Papa said in the leadership meeting, we can't let family members, cousins, mama, dad, or whatever come in to shake us. Because we ain't finna set up no calf in here. We ain't finna build no altar to the enemy just to please the flesh, just to please a family member, just to please a friend. I don't care how long you've been knowing me, but I got to stand on the word of God. And see, that's what Aaron, he got shaken because of their faces. Now he told Jeremiah, don't be moved by their faces. And see, a lot of people get moved by faces. Get moved by people like they say they ain't coming. I don't care. If five people show up, if two people don't show up, we're going to do what God say do. Because it ain't about nothing. We ain't worried about quantity. We're looking at quality.
That's bad. Yes, Lord. Thank
you, Jesus. Quality, people.
Quality.
We don't want to have for devils. People ain't trying to get right. People ain't trying to live right. They just want to come out with the church today.
Thank you, Jesus.
But ain't learned nothing. They ain't trying to change nothing.
Yes.
God said, clean house.
Clean house.
Verse 3 says, the people took the gold rings from their ears and brought them to Aaron. And he received the gold at their hand and fashioned with it a graven tomb and made it a molten calf. And they said, these your gods, O Israel, which brought you up out of the land of Egypt. How many times we give God's glory away? Because we came up a little bit in life and got a better house or a better car. Living a little better. But then don't give God the glory who gave you the ability to get it. See, one, I don't realize that God's the one give us the strength to do what we do. Because the person right now is laying up in a mess, sitting in room 224. I don't know who is 224, but that's what I've seen in the spirit. They lay on their back and can't do nothing for themselves. Because there ain't no limbs where they can move. But they have enough sense in their mind to give God the glory, knowing if it wasn't for God, I wouldn't be here. Because see, the thing about people who got it all and living it all and don't give God that time and don't know God, they can get into a place where nothing else don't matter. Because money can't help this no more. Love can't fix this no more. A relationship can't fix this no more. I'm laying on my back. It ain't nothing I can do but turn my eyes.
Come on, Pastor.
So who they call on? The creator, the source, coming back to the first love.
Come on.
And it's sad sometimes it's safe for people to get like that. Sometimes we have to get flat on our back in the spirit. And God allowed for it to happen where we can get into a place where we know that he's our strength, he's our source.
Thank you, Lord.
So how much is enough is enough. How much do you need to change? How much pressure you need to be put on you for it to change? Because see, a lot of people saying that, again, it's the devil. It ain't the devil because we know in the Word of God, in the book of Job, it said God allowed this.
Yes.
God said, I'm allowing this to happen in your life. I'm allowing for you to go through this in your life where you can see for yourself where nobody got to tell you because God said you already been told. People already been told you, but I'm allowing.